Okay, hello, my name is María Toledo, and I speak about the combustion in porous media, basic and application of the technology. First, I say thank you to Rob Taylor for receiving us here and for our visit, our flash visit for one day or 2 days here. And I speak about this technology. This app is the view of our university. Here is our university. Here is Pacific Ocean in our university. I am professor, associate professor of the Department of Mechanical Engineer. And this is a picture of some of our technology with commercial activities. And the content of my presentation, first an introduction, fundamentals and materials of using in porous media, about inner porous media application, and I'd say commercial activities now with a spin-off of our university. The third is hybrid porous media with the use of some solid fuels inside the porous media. Application is for hydrogen and syngas production. And the last is project ongoing, bakery oven and waste gasification using solar energy. Fundamentals, all we know about the free flame. You see the picture, all see about that. And the pore heat transport properties of the gases result in high temperature gradient, here the peak, and here is a low temperature. No adequate means to affect the temperature distribution here in the part of the flame. Thin reaction layers, high waste gas emission, pollutions, emission from flames, poor flame stability, large combustion chambers. This is a typical use in conventional combustors. And the mechanism of flame propagation mainly is due to heat and mass transport. Here is the gradient of the temperature and also a gradient about concentration. Laminar burner velocity represents the minimum velocity of the coal gas mixture in order to prevent propagation of the flame from. This is typical in free flame propagations. And about the technology, porous media technology, this is the major advantage of porous media technology. High heat radiation output. Here is in the picture, you see the temperature profile of the reactor. Here is the fuel air mixture inside the reactor. Here is all the intensification of the radiation, convection and conduction heat transfer. And the exhaust gases is here, and here is a stabilization of the flame inside the porous media. Low waste gas emissions, ajustable homogeneous temperature level, advancement of free flame outside the porous media, high combustion stability. This is the more principles of this technology. Power modulations. Compact designs, we see in other picture the design of this type of reactors, complex combustion chambers, and process quality independent of burner orientation. This is the difference from free flame and the use of solid, inner solid in this type of burners. Some of the materials used here is zirconia, aluminum oxide, silicon carbide, and other types of materials. This is the maximum temperature for operation of these reactors. And a structure like foams, another type of a structure is possible use in this type of reactor. The typical reactor used in our group in the university. Here is an imagine of the setup. This is the reactor here. And the use of some fuels and air premixed flames is the type of this reactor. They use aluminum balls inside the reactor, temperature measurement, and gas chromatography to see what's up with the emission of the reactor, heat insulation, and other type of things for the use on this reactor in laboratory scales. Internal heat recirculation is one of the more important properties of this type of reactor. Preheater of incoming mixture also, and this is the picture of the recirculation of heat in this type of reactor. This is some pictures about this reactor. This is the flame inside the porous media. The ignition is up of the reactor, and the upstream is going to this position in the day, and in the night is in the picture. And we mainly use alumina sphere or ceramic forms in this type of reactor in our university. Have two modes of operation. Unstable is a free propagation flame, is downstream, and upstream propagation have this type of flames. And the stabilization in the same picture of the other PPT imagine. And effective flame speed is function as equivalent radio use, type of fuel uses, temperature and pressure of the injection of the fuels or the premix with air, matrix conductivity, emissivity, and pore geometry, and have all the effect of the frame propagation or the stability, have to put all these properties together and see what's up with the flame inside the reactor. And temperature and wave speed is the property of this type of reactor. High temperature in the gaseous combustion, solid is more or less in the reaction zone. And the velocity, the wave propagates is at less than 1 millimeter per second. And superadiabatic and subadiabatic is both operational condition of this type of reactor. Temperature, wave velocities, important to know what's up with this type of reactors. And equilibrium versus equivalence radio. All the conventional combustor is here. In this axis, you see the equivalence radio. Equivalence radio 1 is the best to functional. And here is the concentration. And this type of reactor is possible to use ultralean to thermal oxidizers in here, in this number of equivalence radio. I said all the conventional combustor work here. And also it's possible to generate hydrogen and zinc gas here for fuel reforming using ultra-rich from equivalence radio 2.0 and go to more high equivalence radio. The flammability limits in the conventional combustor is in this zone only, and the reactor is possible use here and here for the high heat recirculation in this type of reactor. Some application and commercial activities in our university, we use this type of porous media. It's a radiant burner with high radiation, increase the energy efficiency, and we use this type of reactor in bakery ovens, and we have some certification from Chile, and now we have commercial process ongoing today. This type of reactor use the premix is natural gas air or GLP air mixtures, generate the flame inside the porous media, flue gases here, and this is the combustion zone, and the compact surface and flame trap zone is here. This is the reactor, and have properties like high level of irradiation thermal energy, high homogeneous temperature field, high flame stability, high energy density. This is one of the our development is 2 megawatt per meter square. Extremely compact design, very small size of this type of reactor, very low pollution emission, and flexibly geometry. This is one of the application of this type of reactor. And the other application is for using fuel reformers, like hydrogen and syngas production, using the same type of reactor. And here we have a lot of results and publication in journals about gaseous fuel like natural gas, ethane, propane, butane, biogas, and other, and also liquid fuels, methanol, ethanol, diesel oil, heavy fuel oil, and others, to generate hydrogen and syngas in this type of reactor. And the second type of reactor uses in our lab is not only inert porous media reactor, like filtration combustion, the same type of setup. And we use only solid fuel inside the reactor, like hybrid filtration combustion. And we change some part of inner particle here and put here maybe coal, wood, another type of solid fuel inside the reactor. And the operational is with steam, with natural gas air, or different fuel or gas fuel inside the reactor. We have a lot of publication with this type of reactor, have some patents in this, the use of this type of reactors. And the experimental development, this is a picture of our lab in the university. And this is some picture of the running of the reactor with the use of natural gas, steam, and put some coal here inside the reactor. The results show that filtration combustion or hybrid filtration combustion in this type of reactor can be used to reform gaseous and solid fuel into hydrogen and syngas. This is some combustion model, have a mass conservation, energy conservation for the solid and gas fuel, and also the chemical conservation of the type of, depends on the type of fuels uses in it. And also in the combustion model, we have a Renewable reaction here, and some of the reforming of the fuel reaction. For generate complete combustion or for generate hydrogen and different type of reforming reaction. And this is some result of the our model uses in this type of reactor with the generation of CO, hydrogen, and also some part of product combustion completely. Some results of our this type of reactor are temperature and wave velocity. This is using coal and methane, like ultra-rich reaction, have temperature in this high level, is 1040-1600 Kelvin degrees here. And this is a typical wave velocity of this type of reactor inside. This is one of our publications changing here, vary the volume of solid and inert particle inside the reactor. Other results using wood and methane in ultra-lean reaction have also high temperature here in the reactors is between 1200 Kelvin degrees inside the reactor. This is typical with wave velocity in downstream and upstream using in this type of reactor and comparison with inert and hybrid reactor in different equivalence ratio used in this investigation. Other type of use of different fuels, air and steam, is coal, air, steam here. And the production is hydrogen. We see here the profile of hydrogen generation, carbon monoxide generation. This is the mixture is the syngas production of our reactor. And here is the change varying steam percentage in the reactor, coal percentage in the reactor, and the airflow operational condition to generate hydrogen and carbon monoxide. Other type is using methane and steam. And here you see with different steam vapor in the reactor, different concentration here We see like hydrogen in this picture and carbon monoxide in this picture using different concentration of steam in the mixture inside the reactor. The yield production of hydrogen and syngas is around 60% efficiency for hydrogen conversion, and for hydrogen yield has very high yields for carbon monoxide. In here is close to 80% hydrogen yield, carbon monoxide yield, and for hydrogen yield is close to 60% in the generation of syngas. Our project ongoing is using solar with this type of reactor, like hybrid, using inert particles and also solid fuels inside the reactor. Here we use a solar gasification of coal, and we have a peak temperature of 1,200 Kelvin degrees inside the reactor. The hydrogen production, the average is like 13% in hydrogen in the emission of the product. This is one of the student results about his work. And this is another type of reactor used in the lab that shows Rodrigo, energy lab in our university. The peak temperature using steam from solar was 1,600 Kelvin degrees, and the peak of hydrogen yield was close to 80%. This is using concentrators solar power, and this is used this tube for steam generation inside to use inside the reactor. Other project ongoing is the same use to solar gasification of coal. Is put the hybrid reactor in this position, here put the solar concentrator here. And put here inside all the solar energy to gasification coal inside this reactor. And this is the result of this type of reactor. Using concentrator optics, and this is the PhD student working now to develop heliostat fields and use concentrator solar in the hybrid reactor. This is the hybrid reactor, and this is some parameters we use to develop of this type of reactor. The expected suns is like 3,000, and reflectivity is 85%, mainly optic stage is 3. This is has 2 years of development, and maybe the next year we have some results about this type of concentrator in our developing thesis degree of our student. Other project ongoing with the same using hybrid is this type of reactor. Is a rotary kiln continuous to waste the gasification. We have a big proposal developed in our region in Valparaíso. The same type is rotational to generate here a stable combustion inside the reactor. And we are working with the Institute of Problem of Chemical Physics from Chernogolovka, Russia. And they we have developed some big reactor, some big pilot reactor to use in waste gasification. It's obviously to generate hydrogen and carbon monoxide like syngas. Many things, the same picture of one of our commercial activities. Thanks.